after saying to my friend there, who sat next to me, say hello, mate.
Hello, everyone.
I should have videoed that. I didn't. I got too taken up in the in what was happening. But anyway, there's an idea, look, of what's actually happening now. We're banking through probably a 25 to 30 degree angle. And there's England's green and pleasant land, probably about 5,000 feet below. And we're off to see my friend Peter Freeball in Sweden. And down there is the south coast. Only I don't fancy a swim at the moment. That pleasant land below us is actually Sweden. You see the cloud going by. We're just descending now to land at Stockholm. Plane's just banking into a turn now. You see the agriculture below. You can see the forestry, small farms. Clouds going beneath the plane. Flaps have been raised. Going into a steep banking turn. Coming into land now. Landing gear's gone down. Front of the wing's dropped. Back flaps have just gone back. Weight will soon be taken from the wings, put onto the wheels. There's the airport. And our adventure is just going, it's just to begin. Rather, that's his air brake down there. Yeah, it's closing now, look. His air brake back. Well, we've progressed into the country. We're into the interior now, aren't we?
We certainly are.
And the heat from the sun is tremendous. The view is so much brighter here because the ozone layer, so Ed tells me, is somewhat depleted up here. We've got a very interesting telephone box. But the reason why we stopped here is because I now put on my, well, I had it on all the time, my Jack Law hat. Mr. Jack Law, visits the workshop of Mora Knives. How cool is that? Ed tells me this is the area where they produce what's known as the Dahlener horse, which is one of the symbols of Sweden.
Yep.
Right, okay. And you can see the horses here being painted.
We couldn't visit the factory.
This is just the outlet where they sell the Mora knives.
And
they
tell you that the Dahlener horse has always been carved with Mora knives.
Ah, right. Ed just tells me the Dahlener horse has always been carved with the Mora knife. Maybe I should sell them a Jack Law. And here's some information of the Mora knife. And for those of you that want to, you can pause the video here if you can see any of that. And well, with this camera, it's a bit far out. I suppose it looks a bit small. There's information. That's obviously in Swedish and English. The sign says it all. The sign says it. We are in Peterland. P Peterland. Husky Guard, Barryville Bushcraft School. Welcome to Peterland. Well, here's the man himself. This is Peter Freeble, Barryville Bushcraft.
Meeting
School.
The other man himself.
Yeah. Mr. Jacklaw and Mr. Ed.
Hello, guys.
And we've got the brew on, the first brew.
Absolutely.
Looking forward to this. This is the wind shelter here. There's Peter's last tarp. Peter's camp is there, and his dogs, which I'll show you later on, the husky dogs are all up there. But anyway, it should be an interesting time. Well, we're all off now.
Feeling okay?
Feeling good.
I've no compassion whatsoever with you and your backpack.
Yeah, Peter says that because Ed's got a very lightweight homemade, this is all homemade, all Ed's kit's homemade, and I'll show you that later on in the video. But it's fantastic, extremely lightweight.
Really good stuff. Thanks. So how much kilos do you have now, bud?
7 kilo base weight, 4 kilos of food, and what, this is what, maybe half a kilo.
That's quite good.
11. Yeah, 12 kilos, yeah. Yeah, that's good. Down in the distance there we have some more reindeer. Small herd of reindeer starting to come out. These reindeer are owned by the Sami people. This is the beach. Peter calls this the beach area for the local people. We've got a fantastic view of the local lake, about a kilometre away from where Peter lives. We've met some of the other people here as well. And then we're going to walk on into the wilderness. Right then, this is for Mike, the bearded clam. If you're watching this, Mike, whose feet are these? Well, up to now we've been following the metal paths and tracks to this point here, but from here on our journey lies in the wilderness and making our way through the woods to our campsite. There they go down there, look. Not a sign. Is Ed having a taste of some medicinal plant? We think it may be meadow sweet. You're still standing there, Ed?
Still. Barely. Tastes medicinal.
Yeah.
Mm. But the flowers that make tea is nice. This is just really...
This is the plant here. And I think it's meadow sweet.
But done, it's good to eat this a lot now.
Yeah. It can be used as a tea, so Peter says.
Because
maybe shagga is better.
See you later.
Yeah.
Hey-do.
These tracks you see are reindeer and moose tracks. Yeah. That one there, that's a moose track walking that way.
Slime dissolving properties, so it's good if you have
a Psilosaurus meat eating plant. There's just loads of nodes of this moss everywhere.
Love.
Look at that.
Beautiful. Reindeer food.
Reindeer food. This is called
rock tripe. And when it gets wet, it gets a bit more greeny and a bit
Apparently,
of salad-y.
It's the only
lichen
that has no acid, so you can eat that.
You can eat the other one as well, but you can't eat much of it because of the acid. It will.
And the stories Peter's saying that people surviving just on this alone for many weeks.
After the food.
Yeah.
And I have one like a soup.
There he is, big reindeer. But you can also notice I can notice it very clearly, the lack of aircraft, the lack of civilized noise, or the noise of civilization. That's beautiful, pristine quietness, and every so often lakes like these Yeah, every so often when we're walking through the wilderness, we come across little huts like this, which people rent and come out and they live here for a while. They cut some wood and make a fire. Maybe they fish in the lake. We just stopped for a breather and climbed up her quite a hillside on the way to our destination. We continue to trek through the wilderness. We're still walking to our camping destination, deep in the wilderness, north of Idre. What's this area called, Peter?
That mountain is called Diftedals Variant, which is called, I won't be able to translate that, Diftedals Mountain.
Diftedals?
Yeah.
We're on Diftedals Mountain.
Which we're going to climb up to.
Yeah. We stumble upon this big boulders. In the middle of nowhere. Very high contrast with the light.
And there is more to this kind of place than
definitely. It's poison.
It's a very small one.
Yeah. Think about the dog.
Yeah, you don't want the dog being bitten.
He's looking at me, look. He's looking at me. That's amazing. There it is, it's looking at. You see it? Middle of the screen.
Start hissing if it fits it off enough.
It's making a hissing noise. What sort of snake is that, Peter?
That's a black adder. An adder.
So they could give you a nasty bite?
Yeah, but for the dog it's not a good thing.
No. There's a little snake, look. There he is. He's a little adder.
Nice one.
You leave him alone.
He had made his house under a huge spruce, and the chimney went up into the tree, so the smoke dispersed in the tree.
Very clever.
So he probably was up
there. Peter has led us through approximately, I don't know, 7-8 kilometres, 6 kilometres of wilderness, with very little aid from the compass. And we've walked down to the lake by a boat and by a little hut, which was the design. Beautiful. And there's another hut. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Well done, Peter.
Yeah, thank you. It amazes me as well. I mean, end up at so many places at the lake.
You could have ended up anywhere, but you ended up bang on here.
Exactly, bang on. That's good.
Amazing. Look at that view.
And a funny thing, this is a lake on top of a mountain. That's really funny.
Yeah, yeah. A lake on top of a mountain. So we're about 550 metres ASL.
Yeah, probably higher than that.
Amazing, isn't it? You can drink this water. Drink this. Cheers. No risk of any nasty waterborne diseases.
The queen.
Yeah, the queen.
You see like the head of a woman with their long hair.
Oh, you see, yeah, and the head, yeah. I see in the distance. They call the mountain range in the distance the queen because it looks like a profile. Let me see if I can show you. Zoom in. In the distance.
But what a big country. We've walked. Through this terrain for the last three quarters of a day, following no footpaths. There's the rest of the gang up there. There's Roger. A few stragglers.
Be sure to go foxwalk here, it's such a lot of sharp rocks here.
We have another reindeer on the track ahead. Where are we? There he is, look. Walking towards us. He's a big one. He's just spotted me. Let's have a zoom in. There he is, look. Okay, it's very small, but this is an old birch tree. And in there, the shagger fungus.
Even this is also shagger.
Shagger fungus there. This is shagger fungus.
Oh.
Yeah. And that's where Peter has just cut the shagger fungus off, and you can see the distinctive brown. That'll take a spark very well and make a tea.
Oh. This is a bit harder, I think. That's not easy to harvest that one. This is a hard bit too.
Yeah, you're going for some bark there. Yeah, that's all shagger.
That's good stuff there. That will do for some coffee. Come back here a few years. If it isn't dead, it will actually grow back a bit.
Yeah, yeah. So. Good shagger fungus. Wonderful.
I said I'd track it.
You did, yeah. Well, after approximately 9.5 to 10 kilometre walk through absolutely stunning wilderness, possibly where no man has set foot before, in places.
Somebody claimed it was 11 here.
Yeah. We've arrived at our final destination for tonight, and we're going to camp here for the next three nights. Look at that. Perfect. That's beautiful. Still, calm, quiet. Just what the doctor ordered.